next week. Now, somebody went in someplace today, riding on a something. A donkey, all right? Jesus rode on a donkey into Jerusalem. And as he rode into Jerusalem, the people were waving palm branches in hands. And as they were waving their palm branches, you guys pass some of those down that lane. You guys pass some of those around up there, and maybe you get some down that way. And as they were passing their palm branches and waving their palm branches, they had this word that they were saying. The word was Hosanna, Hosanna. And then they'd say, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Years back. Now, so you guys are ready to try this out. Everybody's here. Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. And everybody would say again, Hosanna! Now, so we got some palms. You guys all have palms. You know what I was thinking about? I grabbed the leftover palms that they had at Emmanuel. Because I was like, you know, we could put palms in the hands of all these people up there. So what I'm gonna do, you guys, I'm gonna try and give each of you guys not just one palm, but two, and I'm gonna ask you guys to take your second palm and pass it along to somebody else who's here. And we're gonna join in a song. It's called All Glory, Laud, and Honor, and it's number 108 in the Green Book. And so we're gonna ask everybody to just a minute to sing that song. We're gonna pray, and then I'm gonna make sure you guys each get a chance to pass that palm to somebody here. So let's pray together. Dear Jesus, thank you for coming.
Thank you for coming.
To set us free.
Hosanna.
Alright, you guys are ready to spread some love, spread some palms. Alright, so take another palm. Yeah, take another palm and pass one out.
Thank you.
Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Also with you.
The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. If you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Faith comes from what is heard, and what is heard comes through the word of Christ.
When they see me in the street, they avoid me. Like a dead man forgotten. I will remind them, and useless as a burning power.
For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life.
But as we prepare for us to go, I have said you are my God.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me.
Will your face shine upon the servant? Save me in your steadfast love.
Now we will sing the hymn, Crown Him with the Crowns, found in the W book, page 107.
Jerusalem,
Jesus would call it the city that kills the prophets. Palm Sunday was the opening moment when Jesus steps into the city, the start of this great week when God is going to rewrite the human story. My destiny, your destiny, the destiny of this whole world rewritten in 1 week. One time, just a few days, Jesus saw what was coming at the end of the week. He saw a cross, but the people didn't know what was coming. Not yet. Crowds, they were so excited Sunday. Jesus knew this day was coming. This was no accident. He had it all planned out. The time, the donkey, everything was planned out years in advance. Jesus was part of the plan. He had this ancient prophecy about to be fulfilled. The people saw a hero coming. They saw a liberator riding in. Jesus coming for them. Well, the crowds, they were so excited on Sunday. Tried to imagine what it felt like. Now, some of you know I'm kind of a history nerd, right? So I've watched enough old World War II newsreel footage. And one of the things that really fascinates me is the welcome that the GIs received as they go into towns in France and Belgium, as these crowds come out, the American soldiers, the Brits, the Canadians, they come, and out come the people with bottles of wine, big hunks of French bread, and they come out, the women and the men, to celebrate. Remember the looks on those people's faces. The feeling of freedom and joy was in the air. Think about Jesus, his arrival in Jerusalem. They welcomed Jesus like the liberator who had already set them free. So much anticipation in the air in Jerusalem and to the people. Palm Sunday felt like a victory parade. When I start to think of Palm Sunday not as the victory parade, but as an entry into the contest. Anybody remember Michael Buffer's trademark phrase for all those boxing matches and basketball games? Let's get ready to rumble. You guys remember that, right? Tell me I'm not the only one who's heard that. This moment when Jesus stepped into Jerusalem. This is right before the real action. Jesus coming to take on the worst that humanity could do. Jesus coming to defeat our real enemies, sin, death, and the devil. He came in the name of the Lord, ready. Ready for battle. Not with fists, not with human weapons. He came with the weapons of the Spirit, with truth, with righteousness, with the gospel of peace, with faith and salvation, with the power of the Spirit, with the Word of God. He came ready to liberate us by enduring a cross. He came not to knock out his human accusers, because through his death, he could defeat death. It's us. People like us who call out, crucify him, crucify him. And he does not come to destroy us. He comes to set us free, us, the ones who crucify him. He doesn't come to vanquish us because he knows we're not his real enemy. Good news of Easter is that Jesus died and rose for all humanity. And this is the story we need. The liberator who comes to defeat death, not by killing humanity, but by setting us free for all eternity. The kind of king who can set you free, that's who Jesus is. And Jerusalem is the place where two events that stand forever linked happened in just 1 week in time. The cross and the open tomb. When we tell the whole story, we hear the whole gospel. But if there's no cross and resurrection together, it's just meaningless suffering. And joy that has no basis, no foundation. See, this Easter, we need to celebrate the King who needs no army, because death can't stop him. We need to tell the whole story about Jesus, who speaks love for us, who stretches out his arms on the cross to extend grace to all. Now, the crowd, they thought they knew who Jesus was. They were so looking forward to someone they thought like Jesus. But I keep on thinking this year as we get closer to Easter, they didn't know who Jesus was. And they have this question, who is Jesus? And not just them, but the question 2,000 years ago. No, this question is around us today in our world. Now, sociologists will tell us that we live in a post-Christian culture. And most of our neighbors under 40, the people your kids or grandkids go to school with, the people who stand behind the counter at that big box store in Mason City or Mankato, most of those people do not know who Jesus is. This is our moment as church to actually tell our story, to actually live out our story, to tell the whole world about a God who would step out of a tomb, who invites us to do the same. See, we have a story to tell about Jesus, the humble servant king. He rode into Jerusalem, just like an old prophecy had said. Zechariah, hundreds of years, generations before Jesus, prophesied about a humble king, riding in on a donkey, on the foal of a donkey. They believed he was going to be triumphant and victorious. Oh yes, Jesus would be victorious, and his victory guarantees our freedom. But the way that victory happens, that's the greatest news of all, because Jesus didn't come to just liberate us for here and now. He came to do battle with the forces we can't defeat on our own. Sin, death, the devil. This battle is cosmic. This battle is eternal, and Jesus came to win. Now, people like me who grew up in church, who had parents who made sure I was present Sunday after Sunday, people like me might know this story. But most of the people in my generation, and most of the people in my kids' generation, when asked, really don't know the story of Jesus. And this is our moment as church to tell our story. Now, to the outside world, Christianity does not make very much sense. We say Jesus comes to teach us how to love each other. But the people of the world look at the church and they can see all the ways we fail to love. People in this world, they've got some serious doubts about us. And sometimes looking at the church, you know what, I got doubts too. And Jesus has come to be our Savior. The people of our age, they look at us and they see our deep conflicts, our lack of love for our neighbors, and they start to wonder about us. The good news is Jesus never forgot the reason he came to earth. But we might be confused. We might get it wrong, but Jesus never forgot the reason to come to this earth. Not even for one minute. He came to save us. He had it all planned out. The donkey, the time, the day, he knew it all. He was king, but the kind of king that was different than the one that people expected. This place, this moment in history was no accident. Jesus rides into Jerusalem a week before Passover. The disciples in the crowd see this hero, a man many hoped would be their future leader, the greatest king Israel could have ever known. But Jesus saw an even greater battle ahead. An ultimate victory that would only come after his death. God, the one we know as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in all mystery and majesty, had it all planned out. So today we remember the crowd with palms in their hands. They waved their branches, and we join them today. They knew this world wasn't right. They could feel it deep in their bones. They knew something needed to change. God was moving, answering the deepest needs of these people's souls and our souls as he rode into Jerusalem. They laid their coats on the ground. They cut branches to make this road smooth. This whole crowd, all these people ready to meet him, overjoyed. They started calling out, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. This word right on their lips, they called out. It literally means in Hebrew, Lord, save us. The children cried out. The men, the women, they all called out as Jesus.
Jesus real near. Hosanna, save us, Lord. Now, if you've got the world on a string and everything is going great, calling out to God doesn't make much sense. But if you or somebody you love is close to the edge, then you know what this word really means. Hosanna, save us, Lord. Hosanna, come, Lord Jesus, and help us. So the people all have this one question on their lips. Who is this? Who is this? This is the question I think our world is going to be asking us. Who is this Jesus? The one who gives you hope. The one who comes to be the way, the truth, and the life. Who is this Jesus? This week we remember Jesus, the life, the death, and the new life he comes to give to us. For that good news I give thanks and praise, and I say glory be to Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, for the end. Hymn is number 660 in the I want Jesus to walk with me, number 660. Thursday, and then Friday is a community service. service, we've got seven members of the community who are going to be sharing a thought about one of Jesus' sentences, or one of the words Jesus said on the cross. And I encourage you to come and join us. The community choir is taking shape, and I think it is going to be a beautiful, beautiful service. And I will be here on Friday night at 7 o'clock. And see Carol if you want to join in the community choir for that night. Invite you to stand up and join us if you can as we continue our service. It's going to be on page 29 in the front part of the loop. In Christ you have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. We believe in you and are marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Build yourselves up upon your most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of God. Look forward to the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ. If anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. Behold, everything has become new. God has given us the ministry of reconciliation. Therefore, let us be reconciled to God and to one another. Gracious God,
have mercy on us. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. Uphold us by your Spirit, so that living in us with you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you into eternal life. Amen. Sisters and brothers, rejoice. Mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Take a couple minutes and share a sign of God's peace with the people around you.
Thank you.
God, in the abundance of your steadfast love,
call us from death to life, from silence to speech, from idleness to action. With these gifts we offer ourselves to you,
and with church through all the ages, we give thanks for your saving love, Jesus Christ our Lord. As God's people call to love one another, we pray for the needs of the church, the human family, and all the world. Father God, we give you thanks for Jesus. We give you thanks for the good news of his love that has no end. Help us to tell the story of his cross and of his rising to this world. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Father of us all, we give you thanks for our brothers and sisters in Christ in every land, in every nation. Unite us in purpose. Unite us in hope. Unite us in love. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of the nations, you know the story of every person. We pray for our nation and the people of every land. We pray for neighbors near and far whose lives have been turned over by tornado, by flood, by earthquake, by war. We pray that you would raise up people in your church to care for neighbors in need, to work for justice and peace. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Oh God, you know the needs of every person, of every family. Hear us, O God, as we pray for your love to flow in our homes, in our lives, in our words, and in our actions. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God, we pray today for those who are lonely, for those who are hungry, for those who feel forgotten. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of all hope, we remember before you today Bonnie, Nick, Connie, Ava, Lisa, and all others who we name before you. You are our healer and our hope. God of mercy, hear our prayer. As we come close to Easter this year, oh God, we ask your comfort for those families who have an empty place. Those lives that have been taken from us mean so much, O God. We ask your mercy and your blessings for all the grief. God of mercy, hear our prayer. All these things and where else you see that we need, grant us, O God, for the sake of Christ who died and rose again, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We go today with a three-part blessing. May the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ fill you with every spiritual blessing. Amen. May the God of faithfulness and encouragement grant you to live in harmony with one another in accordance with Christ Jesus. Amen. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So go in peace, love, and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. And our closing song is on the back of our bulletins. Right on, right on, in majesty.